Curse you, Audacity. This is try number two. Okay, here I am back in Brinstar, where we left off last time. Jumping up the blocks. Not sure why there's a wire fence here when I can just jump up the blocks or go down there. Whatever, it's all cool. Options. Extra options are always good. And then red switch blocks, which means that I've obviously missed the red switch palace a long time ago. But I'm gonna get over that. Coming the next four videos. Yeah. On said fourth video, I'll probably not be doing these kinds of commentaries anymore. I'll probably actually be doing them as live as possible as I can. That must hurt poor Yoshi with Luigi just kind of sitting on his neck like that. Moving on, we go into the mystery saucer! And it starts up with Chrono Trigger music. I have to be honest with you, I haven't grown up with Chrono Trigger, but I did play the one for the DS that came out. And I had great fun with it. I enjoyed it and everything. However, there's a different Square RPG that I haven't grown up with and played since I heard everybody liked it. That one was Secret of Mana. Out of the entire series that I have played, which includes Sword of Mana for the Game Boy Advance and Children of Mana for the DS, that one blew. I can't say I was too fond of Secret of Mana, I'm sorry, I just didn't like that one. It seemed like it was trying to combine turn-based RPG with action, and that didn't sit well with me. Fireball to the top of the cap, which shouldn't really kill him so much as make him need to go out into the hat store and buy a new hat. But anyway, Luigi murders two old men in hot blood. Why not cold blood? Because, well, Luigi's spitting fire. He can't possibly be cold-blooded if he's spitting fire. Thwimps. I hate them. But that's just me, personally. And I keep hitting those spark bulb things. I really don't know what to call them. I think I'll call them muncher plants replacements because that's what they are. They're not spikes because they're animating. And quick laser! Now for a while here I kind of forgot that I could actually jump through them as opposed to being forced to kind of mess around with my jumps. The graphics were just too weird on these things that I couldn't figure it out, but that's just me. I'm sure the rest of you all probably figured out what that was and, got around it just fine. And spark bulb! I keep wasting hits on those suckers. Of course I would have to do a running jump here, wouldn't I? Makes it actually a pretty sneaky way to force someone to jump into one of those spark bulbs. Bowser fire in the face! Then more thwomps to maneuver around as well as the more spark bulb things. Must not touch quick lasers. Must not touch quick lasers. For they would have been my downfall. I touched them. And I'll have to admit, while this boss is a good idea, it's kind of not executed well here. It's just my opinion here that this boss, being 5 minutes long, is probably too long. As you can probably tell, there's no way I can possibly harm him because of all these blocks coming down in the way. fireball wouldn't get to him, and I have to be at least one square away from him to actually hit him with my cape, so I'm kind of forced to dodge his boomerangs for a while. I wish I had one of those boomerangs that magically came back. That would have made boomerangs so much more fun for me. Although I'll have to admit, some of these 5 minutes will be me failing, but that doesn't excuse the fact that this boss is just a touch too long. Of course, it's partially my fault that there actually are yellow blocks here that will drop apples and give me hearts. That bit's my fault. But again, this boss takes up like almost 200 Mario units in time. It's a bit too long for my taste. Boomerang! Boomerang again! There's a heart I could have gotten, but I didn't because I totally missed the Switch Palace, and I know where it is now, 4 videos later. So of course I forget to turn around at the last second. Now I'll have to say, among all of the Wind Waker boss themes, this one was my favorite here. But it's a bit too quiet in this Mario MIDI version. It doesn't really have quite that dynamic taste, in my opinion. 2 minutes left until I can finally stomp the sucker. Whew, boy. Finding things to talk about. Let's see here. That weirdo two square wide block looks like it has a mustache. Like those funny mustaches in old cartoons, where you could totally tell anyone who had that was a villain. Let's see here, so many spark bulbs here, including this one in the bottom left corner, which has been a pain in my rear when I was recording this. Here I go and fail like 50 times on these stupid boomerangs. The same spot at least twice. Start to wisen up, and then I hit a spark bulb. I forget to lay save states, and I get hit by a boomerang, and I have to do this all over again, getting hurt by the first boomerang at least 3 times. Good lord, I sucked! Yes, we do.
Okay, I'm not gonna be back out there. I love you.
Alright, now let's see. Still dodging freaking boomerangs, I finally wisen up, use my apple, and then get hit by a boomerang that's coming back around. Oh no. Oh my goodness, there's a gap! I can finally get to him, right? Well, just watch. Fail. Luckily, I placed the save state in a pretty good place. I kill him and then nothing for a while. And then abrupt end of level! That totally confused me there. The screen didn't even go dark like it was a boss. Or anything like that. Quit trying to get into the video. Alright, obviously I'm not going to hit the castle because I still have so many more side paths to go, so back to the Starbound Bridge I go. I don't know why in the world I decided I would record the entire level all over again up to the point where I fell into the water, but whatever. Okay, so obviously I don't screw up with that spike a second time. figure out that bombs can't hurt these sniper chucks. So I will wait patiently down there so that I might get my Yoshi. If only I was small and could get to him a lot faster. Then again, being small would mean only one hit left, and that's no good. I love tricking those stupid ceiling spikes into falling. It's like they have their own minds. I'm gonna fall on this dork if he walks just one step away from me. Above him. I don't even know why those creatures are considered spiked monsters when those spikes look kind of flabby there. Not at all pointy. So he'll eat things. So Yoshi will eat things spewing fire. He'll eat things that are completely covered in spikes, but he totally will not swallow a Koopa shell. Logical, right? I tried to fly over, but obviously that wasn't going to fly with the creator. And so I accidentally burned my only way of actually making it through the stage. Bear with me here for like 2 minutes as I totally fail trying to up along these note blocks instead, not having known that they were actually supposed to be obstacles for flying around. So I'll keep on screwing around with that sniper chuck and that old man down there. And some more spikes. It isn't for a while that I realized that, I totally needed that blue Koopa shell. I even tried to bail off a Yoshi there. It was here that I totally realized that I needed the blue shell, so I decided to see if there was a way to make it respawn. To my dismay, I kind of figured out that there wasn't, so I had to come back to this level using a jump cut and using start and select to come back to the midpoint. Alright, here we go. I do this perfectly now that I have the blue shell. Go figure. But despite the fact that Yoshi has wings, he gets new ones and becomes blue. And so we're back to cave story music as I fly along, trying to dodge quick lasers, old men, whatever the heck those red guys shooting fireballs and spewing fire out their shoes are. Ordinary sumo brothers? These weirdo mecha thwomps. An old man on a winged ball. And the toony nut! Oh crap, Luigi, you probably ought to take that back to Symmetry City before it... Oh... too late. Okay, all joking aside, obviously something called Starbound would have a star warp on its secondary exit. Makes sense to me, anyway. And now we're in Starland... desert. I actually had to look this up. This was Hardman's theme in Mega Man 3. Ugh, ever since I screwed up with Commando Man, I've kind of forgotten which stage's music belonged to who. Not to mention, I only really found so many boss level themes to be all that memorable. I have the Mega Man Anniversary Collection, and I still can't remember every boss's theme exactly. Kinda has something to do with I haven't played in them all in a while. But besides that, I jump on this mechanical egg-spewing chicks from Mega Man. And snakes are popping out of the ground. Last I remembered, they were dark nuts. And that ranger dude, for some reason, has fight with Luigi, but that's not really a big deal here because the video's over. See you next time, folks.